people don't go deep enough, so don't worry about overcutting it. Alright. Clean that up a little more. Clean that one up a little. Just go over and clean it up as you're going. See, I've got a little chip there. Whoops, that was out of view. Little chip there. Now I use my gouge to just work on this, just little scoops. Trying to make it look like feathers. You can use a little Dremel and just really wire it up a little bit. I don't like power tools, so I just try to get it to look like something with hand tool. See, it got a little bit of rough look. It's hard to see with these, with the grain of this cottonwood. Mark there. I'll turn this upside down. Take some of that out. Same on these quills, but I'll get a little piece of sandpaper. And on those, I'll sand the pencil marks off. Now I'll sand the whole thing. Taking those pencil marks off. Don't sand it too much or you'll sand all your stuff in it. Just kind of hit it a little bit. Yeah, it's looking pretty good. Now we take our little V2, go ahead and put the rest of those beads on. Sometimes I'll just do it like this. Just the look of beads. Since I'm showing you this, we'll do the whole thing. Now undercut the front of that beadwork as much as you can so it looks like it's going under the hair. Or the hair goes under it, I mean. That also gives it some good shadows, see? More shadows, the better it is, in my opinion. Okay, got a good shadow right there, so I want to try to get some on this side. Using this 1/8 inch V. And now you can really see the shadows on these ones, and this one you can't. But now we'll put the shadows in there. Cut under that feather quill. So you can get some real deep shadows. Start seeing some really good shadows in there. Just a little more beadwork on there. Personally, I like to do them all. Every single bead. I'm in no hurry in my life. I am enjoying it. Staying calm. Peace. I'm at peace with myself and my Creator. That's what counts in life. Being happy with yourself and your Creator. I love my country too. Okay. Yeah, I've been watching the Olympics and they're pretty fun. Okay. Keep on putting them in. They don't have to be perfect. Because the eye, that's one secret the artists use. The eye sees what it wants to see, no matter what you put in there. But if you put enough detail that the eye can finish it, the person is much happier with the piece because they can interpret it the way they want. I've done paintings that some people see stuff in. The next person looks at it and he sees something totally different. It's the eyes that are doing all the trickery. Okay. See? It's not uniform. I don't want it uniform. Uniform is not good on the eyes. It just doesn't make you feel comfortable. So if you get non-uniform stuff, the eye gets to play around and decide what it wants to see. Now we got all the laterals, the horizontals. Now we'll come in here and shape each bead. It looks like super detail, but it's not. Yeah, what I was talking about was Impressionism. They put just enough stuff to make you work on seeing what they want you to see or stuff that you want to see. And if you see something good in a piece of work that makes your mind and eyes happy, you'll be more likely to be able to sell that piece to someone that appreciates it and that will take care of it and hand it down for generations to come. That makes me happy. I can make someone else happy with their carving and their painting, then I am happy. And that makes me happy and glad. Okay. So that didn't take too long to do. That's a nice looking war bonnet. Take a little bit more under there. And to make that stand out a little bit more, cut under the forehead. See, that's where if you're doing the face, make sure you block in the bonnet first. Yeah, just like this. Just make sure you just block in like we started. That way you'll have a nice piece. Now we'll put a little sealer on it to see what she looks like. That might look pretty cool. You can use any sealer you want, but I like Liquitex Semi-Gloss Sealer. It's an acrylic sealer. You put a little bit on there, you can see the milky white. Just keep rubbing it in, dragging it across. Don't want it too thick because your carving will turn milky on you. And look at the colors coming out. That's just pretty nice. If you want, you can add a little color to the beadwork or paint them red. I use burnt sienna as my red, so it's not too bright. I don't really like bright colors on my carvings. They don't look professional. Just put it that way. Just rub and rub until you get all that off. You can put a couple coats on, but let the first one dry for a little bit. I almost got too much on there, so I'm gonna drag it around. This is how you dry your brush up. Keep some of that off. Keep working it in. Work it in all the cracks. This is a bristle brush. Number 7. Paid $1 for it. It's from China. And I don't want to buy good brushes because I beat them up so quick. can clean these brushes good and you can get probably 20 carvings out of a brush. You can see it turning a little milky. But once it starts drying, it'll clear up on your carving. Make sure you don't use too much when you add it to the piece. Let's put a little here. White bark right here makes it look pretty good. You can see all that pretty grain in that wood. Okay, I hope you enjoyed. If you didn't, that's okay. If you did, that's really good. I hope you got something out of the DVD on how to put a war bonnet on your Indian carving. Thank you very much for watching. If you get a chance, go to redhawkoriginals.com and check out some of my carvings and paintings and enjoy them. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. See you later.